Okay, painting the pear. First and last name at the top. Your first and last name at the top. And your hour. Okay, now the pear is sort of a yellow green. So the first thing I have to do is mix up my yellow green. I'm going to take just a little bit of green. This is going to be my main color for the entire pear. And all color mixing is all trial and error. You have to just try to figure it out as you go. Okay. So I would have my pear in front of me so I can really look at those colors. And take some of my yellow, a little bit of my green. Okay, that looks pretty good. And I'm going to go ahead and paint my pear with my yellow green. Go around my stem. Remember, I'm going to make the color for my stem. Don't make your color for your stem out of the same complementary colors that you're using on your fruit. It blends in too much. So my yellow green pear, I'm getting my base coat of color on. And the complementary color of green is red. The complementary color of yellow is violet. So the complementary color of yellow green is red violet. So I'm going to rinse out my brush and get a little bit of red violet on my paint palette. Little bit of red. Little bit of violet. Oh, I already have some violet there. And make myself a good red violet for my shadows. And then mix it in. Just a little bit. Oh, that's so dark. Oh my goodness. I should have made more of that. Ho ho ho. Make it there. Can I make it there? I can make it there. Look at that. And mix over there. Alright. That's looking better. I'm going to get sort of a brown shade at the edge there. So start making this a little bit darker on the edge. Using my directional lines. Pear has a smooth texture, so I don't need to use a stippling on it. An orange, same concept, but the orange has a stippling, kind of rough texture to it too. Now the pear, what's unique about the pear is it is round. It has a sphere at the bottom and then a cone at the top. So I round this out a little bit with my darker colors, start bringing in that yellow, green in through here and blending that together. And I bring that all the way around here so that I really draw attention to this sphere here that's separate from the pear up here. I'm starting to get this blended together. I don't want to do that. I really create a round form in through here and then a cone shape at the top. Blend this together a little bit and through there. And then the pear, you do the stem the same way as we did the other ones, and then the pear gets a highlight. I think I can use this light color here and give it, oh, the sun's over here, so I know my highlight is going to be somewhere over here. It's not always three little dots. It depends. In a classroom like we have, you've got the square lights over the top. Sometimes they're more of a square shape. Maybe it's just one line, maybe it's more than one dot. So. All right, pear.
Make your pear.